How important it is to be on TV and how important it is to win on TV. Both of them want to look real good, so that makes for an interesting match.
It does indeed, and once again they close in collar and elbow. And it is, neither man got an impasse here. Good block on the part of both men. And so neither man able to gain an advantage position here. It'll be interesting to see what sort of a counter they come with. Oh, the referee broke it up, and it was Garvin closing in on the break.
Well, Garvin pulled a little bit of a cutie right there, and I think all I can do is say that that's how important that TV belt is to him. He wants to win, and Brett Wayne was just a little bit outfoxed there. Brett Wayne doesn't have the experience that Garvin does, but he's learning, and I bet you he learned an awful lot in that move.
He did indeed. He has been very trusting up to this point, but I'm sure he's going to become a more cautious competitor. A study here in leverage, and it is Wayne breaking it up very nicely, drives Garvin back. Garvin started to charge in, but Wayne was set and ready for him. And so Garvin, I think, looking at Brett Wayne with perhaps some added respect.
Well, you know, as many times I've been in the ring and I looked at a man and I thought, well, that's not going to be too much work for me, so I could maybe loaf or take it easy. I think Garvin may have underestimated Wayne, although I don't know that he should have, because Brett Wayne in the last several weeks has really shown himself to be a top competitor, a really gutsy kind of guy. And maybe now Garvin believes it. Maybe he realizes it. Both of them making a move here. Both of them making a mistake. Now it's a matter of who can recover first.
Excellent point, as both men went up with flying drop kicks and in the air simultaneously. It is Garvin who started to take the advantage here, but Wayne may have it for the third. Fought for a minute, we had a new TV champion.
It was awful close, and Garvin knows it. Garvin right now is going to size him up again, as you mentioned. Maybe he overestimated or underestimated, I should say, Brett Wayne. Locking up again. We'll go for it once more, see what happens.
Side headlock now by Brett Wayne. Ronnie Garvin trapped for the moment. And certainly Wayne has come with some real surprises in this. And Garvin once again taken to the canvas, a full hip lock takedown. Garvin now gets the head scissors on Wayne. Has it locked in to the hollow of the knee, but all right, Wayne is now going to have some breathing problems. And once you start cutting off that air supply, that starts to hinder your capabilities. All right, Wayne back to his feet. And Garvin maybe showing a little sign of desperation here.
Well, at the moment, he's trying to hold back, I think, in terms of trying to wrestle scientifically. But there again, that TV belt is so important. It means a lot of money. It means prestige. In a way, I almost can't blame a guy for wanting to go a little bit more for it and making sure that he keeps that belt. You know, we watch these two guys up here, both great amateur wrestlers, good professional wrestlers. We're going to be seeing another couple of outstanding wrestlers here coming up in Rick Rude and Chief Joe Lightfoot.
That is going to be an interesting match indeed. Garvin up and over his man, leapfrogged over. And a good drop by Garvin, rolling reverse. Brett Wayne breaks it up, however, and is back to his feet, and it's Wayne.
You want to know something, Gordon? I look at these guys, the way they're moving around. Both of the men are over 230 pounds, 220, 231, 32, something like that. If anybody ever has to question as to the athletic ability or the conditioning of the wrestlers, all they have to do is pull a chair out in the kitchen, get up on that chair, step back down, step back up, and maybe do it just for a minute, just for a minute, and see what it does to them. Here you've got these guys been going full tilt for what, 6-7 minutes now, nonstop.
They have gone 10 minutes, and that would be equivalent to three quarters of a pro football game. It has been nonstop action, and neither man. Exactly. In fact, if anything, the intensity has picked up. Neither man wanted to hear that bell, although I have a hunch that maybe Ronnie Garvin might be just a little bit relieved to hear that bell, because Brett Wayne still has a tremendous amount of power going. But the match is, in fact, a draw. Fine display of sportsmanship there, as it was Brett Wayne and Ronnie Garvin shaking hands after that. And as I said, of course, they fine display of sportsmanship and